What to know before buying a home in an HOA. First of all, what is an HOA? HOA is an abbreviation for Homeowners Association. An HOA is an organization in a subdivision, planned community, or condominium complex that makes and enforces rules for the benefit of the community as a whole. There are state and local laws that HOAs must abide by, regardless of what they put in their own CC&Rs and rules. Most people think of condos or townhome communities when they think of an HOA, but other types of properties, including detached single-family homes, can also be part of an HOA. An HOA usually has an elected board of directors made up of people who own property in the community. The CC&Rs will outline the term lengths and responsibilities for members of the board. Most often, the board of directors will employ a professional community management company to handle the day-to-day managing of HOA business. Management will collect dues, pay association bills, get bids on work to be done around the property. They'll also send out communications to the HOA membership and make sure that HOA taxes are paid, oversee any repair projects as needed, and address any homeowners that are in violation of rules. They also hold meetings as required by the CC&Rs and take calls when emergencies arise. And they also make sure the HOA is in compliance with any laws. So look, people love to hate their HOAs. Some people will never ever consider buying a property that has an HOA. I get it. Some people have had horrible experiences trying to deal with an HOA, but they can also be a good thing. When living in close quarters, perhaps even sharing some walls with the neighbors, imagine your neighbor's home looked like something out of an episode of Hoarders. What if the neighbor kept parking in your parking space over and over and over? It's private property, so calling the police may not help you that much. What if the roof starts leaking in your bedroom, but in order to fix it, the entire roof of the building needs to be replaced and you share that building with four other owners? How will you get your neighbors who don't have a leak in their bedroom to chip in on the cost of the roof when it's only affecting you? You get the idea. These are just a few examples of when you'll be glad you have an HOA, assuming it's being run and managed properly. I've personally owned three properties that had HOAs. I sat on the board of directors of one of those properties for about 13 years. And let me tell you, the stories I could tell you about my experiences would make for some really fun and entertaining conversation now that I'm no longer dealing with it. Okay. I've personally experienced neighbors who were hoarders, people who parked anywhere they wanted and blocked in other people from being able to even move their cars in or out. I've had to call tow trucks to tow cars away. I even had a neighbor sue me once because I had a water leak in my kitchen, even though my insurance addressed all the problems and fixed everything that went wrong in my unit and in hers. She still wasn't happy. I've been on numerous calls with association attorneys to get advice on how to handle unreasonable homeowners. Homeowners that put surveillance cameras up pointing directly into the windows of their neighbors. Homeowners that were fighting other homeowners over their barbecue pits and their pets. And even dealing with a lawsuit with a builder because 30 years earlier, they did not build the parking garage correctly, followed by 10 more years trying to get it actually fixed. I've also had to deal with some bad community managers, finding new ones, scrambling when suddenly the manager we have no longer wants to have us as a client. It's stressful because you can't just let everything go. So as I said, people love to hate their HOAs. If you find yourself in that situation, the best cure is to get elected to the board. You will quickly find out as a board member if the board or the management is just simply terrible or if their job is way harder than you ever imagined. So, if you're considering buying into an HOA, here are some things you should know. One, there are rules. Every HOA has rules that are unique to that property. There is no standard set of rules. So when you're looking to buy into an HOA property, be sure to get a copy of all the HOA docs and read every single line, every one of them. Remember, you need to read every single line and understand those documents because you're the one that has to live by those rules. Don't expect your real estate agent to be the one to point out the rules to you that you may or may not like. It's very subjective and there's no way for your agent to know if a particular rule is going to be a problem for you. For example, if you have a large family and you like them to come over and use your swimming pool every Sunday all summer long, you need to check for any rules about using the pool. If the rules allow for 3 guests, but you plan on having 12 guests over every week, you're going to have a problem with your HOA and probably your neighbors, and you could be facing some fines for violating them. If you have pets, make sure to check the rules on pets to be sure that they work for you. No one else can decide for you if the rules are suitable for you. So please, please, please take the time to read every page and make sure that the rules are rules that you can live with. Another bit of advice. Make sure to read all the meeting minutes, at least for the past 6 months. Even the past year is better. It's a little bit like playing detective, but read all the minutes and see if there's anything in there that concerns you at all. Here's a situation I was in. I was considering buying an investment property that was in an HOA about a year ago. I had looked at properties in the community before, so I thought I knew enough to make a decision. For some reason, I decided to Google the name of the HOA to see if anything came up. And oh boy, did I uncover a can of worms. That little Google search led me to a webpage posted by an owner in the community. It was clear from viewing the page that there were many homeowners that were really unhappy and in disagreement with the board and management. In fact, they were teaming up to hire their own attorney to take the sitting board and management to court. Now, this could have been a whole lot of nothing because, as I've said, people love to hate their HOA. But when I saw the GoFundMe page where owner after owner after owner in this community had donated large sums of money in the thousands of dollars to pool their money together to hire an attorney to represent them, I knew it was not just a few unhappy people. Some of these owners were donating thousands of dollars. Thousands. This was a serious matter, and I sure did not want to buy a rental property in a community that was likely going to see a lawsuit in the near future. Number two, does the HOA have enough money in reserves? Part of your disclosure packet will include financial statements for the HOA. It's important to look at those statements and be sure the HOA has enough money in reserves. One way is to look at what percentage the HOA is funded. Look at the last reserve study of the HOA. A reserve study is done by an independent company who goes through every detail and looks at everything an HOA covers in their expenses and determines how much life expectancy is left before that item has to be replaced or repaired. They may say something like, the roof is 5 years old and there's a life expectancy of 20 years and it has 20 years left. And in 20 years, they anticipate that replacing the roof will cost $50,000. The reserve study will even look at things like pool furniture and factor that into the cost. Then there is the total expected expenses. Let's say it's $500,000. If the HOA's reserve savings account, not the operations account, but the reserve account, has $500,000, then that HOA is fully funded. That means it's in great shape financially. Now, I will tell you from experience, that a fully funded HOA is a very rare unicorn. It almost never happens. When I joined the board of one of my HOAs, I think we were about 5% funded. 5%, seriously. It was pretty close to bankrupt. By the time I left, we had reached a point of being fully funded, and at one point even more than fully funded. I can tell you that this is something other homeowners don't always appreciate. They wonder why they're still paying dues every month if the HOA is fully funded. But trust me, it's hard work to keep an HOA well funded. Number three, here's another question people often have is if I'm not on the board, do I get any say? And the answer is yes. Homeowners are encouraged to get involved and attend meetings. Attending meetings is the best way to know what's going on in your community. Every meeting, there will be an opportunity to speak and mention any issues you might have. Keep in mind that in California, at least when I was still on the board was not allowed to respond to any issues that were brought up during a meeting. They can only discuss what is already on the agenda. I mention this because it makes people mad, and sometimes they get very upset with board members thinking the board is trying to avoid their problem, but it's a legal issue and there's nothing the board or the management can do unless the laws have changed. So keep in mind when you go to the meeting, and the board doesn't address your concern right there in that meeting, it's because they need to have it on the agenda. Four, make sure there's no pending lawsuits. It's very hard to get a loan in a community that has a lawsuit pending. So even if you can get a loan to buy it, If that lawsuit extends over a number of years, you may have a hard time selling it if you decide to sell it sooner rather than later. And 5, review the HOA's insurance policies. Make sure they have current insurance and understand exactly what it covers. If there is a fire in your building, will they rebuild your unit or just the outside of your unit? What about the inside? Will it cover displacement costs for the time you need temporary housing? Here's an interesting situation. A friend of mine had a fire in her community where 8 units were no longer suitable for occupancy because of some other issues that were happening with the HOA being mismanaged. They were unable to proceed with rebuilding for over a year, even though the insurance was covering the claim. Then the owners filed a lawsuit against the HOA because of the delay, which further complicated and further delayed everything. I think when it was all said and done, it was more than 4 years before those units were habitable again. Insurance coverage is important. If this happened to you, I'm sure you'd want insurance that would cover your temporary housing because those people still had to pay their mortgages and their homeowners dues, even though they couldn't live in their property for 4 years. So 6, what is the HOA responsible for? By now, you probably know what I'm gonna say. Read your CZNRs and see what's covered. I cannot stress that enough. So I hope this gives you a better understanding of HOAs and that I didn't scare you away from considering buying one either. There's lots of benefits to living in an HOA too, which I'll share in a future video. So be sure to subscribe to my channel and ring the bell so you're notified when there's new videos on my channel. I'm Maria Diora. I'm a real estate agent located in the San Francisco Bay Area. If you're looking to buy or sell in the Bay Area, give me a call. If you need a recommendation for an agent in your area, let me know. Send me an email. All my contact information is in the description below. And I'll see you in the next video.